Hey, epitome. Hey, hey, I'm just doing my last bits of promo blasting before we get going. Also, well, I know that Coffee is also doing a big stream today, a collab slash duel, I think, with Nia, so I don't know how long I'll be going on this, because that'd be a little weird to, excuse me, just kind of interrupt, or not interrupt, but like, try to compete with that. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see what I end up getting through today. Yeah, Coffee the Pooh. Coffee the Pooh. Coffee the Pooh. Funny little VTuber all stuffed with fluff. It's Coffee the Pooh. Coffee the Pooh. Funny little lesbian bear. I was saying this last time too, but Epitome, do you remember that one, in the 90s, that one animated series of Winnie the Pooh where it had just such a absolute banger of a soundtrack for the opening? Like, a Winnie the Pooh animated cartoon had no right to have a theme song that bumpin', you know? Pooh Bear, Winnie the Pooh Bear, rumbly tumbly climb in a honey tree. Pooh Bear, I know you're out there. I don't actually know any of the words, literally any of the words beyond that. Looking for fun, chasing those honeybees. Yeah, that sounds right. I don't know if it's right, but it certainly sounds right to me anyway. All those are very good emotes. Let's see. I think this channel. Hey, Coffee. I'm gonna do my best not to try and do anything that actually competes with your stream, but well, it depends on how much the audience decides they want me to stream too, I guess. Thoughts on owls? Okay, in general, I would say I'm a fan of owls. I think they're cute. I've pet owls before. Like, not pet owls, but I have interacted and, like, physically pet owls before. That was pretty cool. Yeah, owls are good. Oh, that question. Yeah, I could be up for doing that kind of cosplay. Sure. Oh, Coffee, also, could you give me a reminder, when exactly is your collab stream starting? Fortunately, we really don't have too much more I need to do for Coffee the Pooh. Well, she really all came together in basically just one stream. I feel really good about that, I'm not gonna lie. like, strictly speaking, going by the example of Winnie the Pooh, this is basically already done. But I want to at least add a little bit of highlight. Highlights. Okay, and shrinking the bush. Add some stitch lines? I don't know, that isn't really a thing on the references that I've been using for Pooh. Like, there's not really stitch lines, you know? Some refs have them? I guess that's fair, but I'm going for at least this iteration of Pooh. Alright, so let's do, I guess, a little bit of this kind of shading. And then I'll go back through. Yeah, I'll go back through and edit in the rest. Hey, Obsidia! That is a cute bear. Looks like it would top an elf. Hmm. Oh, so while you're here, Coffee, can you give us any insight into what you're going to be doing for your duel today with Nia? Do you have any big strategies that you're going to employ? Any kind of things that you've been prepping for the stream? What's your strategy going into your duel today, Coffee? Do you feel good about your odds? I haven't played in a while. But we're going to warm up, and then I'll just get her too flustered to fight back. Ooh. Now that might be a tough sell. I've seen in Nia's streams that she's managed to start to harden herself a little bit against compliments from the audience. Do you have any particular strategy you're going to employ to get inside her head beyond that? I know Coffee can answer for herself, but I think that Nidhogg 2 or Nidhogg is going to be at least one of those games. She's never been in call with me before, so I'm planning to use the power of my voice. Ooh. Ooh. Now, flip side, is there anything you are particularly worried about in today's matchup? Both of you are fairly high seed going into all of this, but is there anything about your opponent you are particularly worried about seeing or at all concerned about, or do you think this is just gonna be an in the bag victory for you? And as an addendum question, I'm pretty rusty with Nidhogg, and she's a bit of a gamer, so if I play fair, it might not go my way. Totally understandable. And here in the independent VTuber, VStreamer competitive circuit, we think that you have to take every possible advantage you can get. That's totally fair play. Now, what exactly are the stakes for today's duel? I remember seeing them discussed a little bit, but as I recall, I think they might have gotten some pretty high stakes things going on in there, hmm? Would you like to publicly confirm what you're playing for today? I heard a rumor that it was one of your hands in marriage. Is that true? We've both joked about them, but we have a time set aside to discuss proper stakes. Ooh. Ooh. So I assume then that's going to be revealed in the stream proper? Alright, let's see. I need to clean up the hair a bit. Boo, 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 boo. I'm leaning towards, if I win, she marries me. If she wins, I marry her, but we'll see. Ooh, so you're playing for, what, like, last name rights? Does that mean she would have to become Niyakuma, or you would have to become Coffee Galgos? Also, side note, Galgos does sound like it does sound weirdly like a Greek last name. I think I have an uncle from Galgos somewhere in the family tree. Yeah. Yeah, got stray hairs in my mouth. Right. Okay, let's zoom out and take a look. Okay, I need to fix this little bit back here. Your hair is so unruly. It is. Like, don't get me wrong, I appreciate my hair, and now that I've gotten to a point in my life where I can really grow it out to a length that I like, I appreciate it even more. But it is its entirely own creature that I do not make the rules as to how it exists. I just have to live by them, and sadly, so does everyone else who lives around me. So I hope you're getting ready for that. I will make Victorian hair jewelry when you move in. Is that a promise or a threat? I can't exactly tell. Both. Okay. If you say so. Okay. A little bit of flyaways up there. Oh, hey, Noctua! It's been a while. How have you been? Actually, I don't know if I've ever actually seen you in stream here before, so welcome, welcome. We are doing pretty good, or I'm doing good at least. I finished a hugely important, on a personal level, and totally unimportant in a grand scheme of things, audition for the HoloLive group today, and finally submitted it. I've talked about it so much on these streams that I don't really want to give it too much more airtime unless it's something that people are just, like, super curious about, but I'm not expecting it to actually go anywhere. But I knew that I had to do it for my own, like, peace of mind, so I didn't wake up in a cold sweat years from now wondering, oh, what if I had done this? I can just say that, hey, I did my best. And that's now finished and done with. Now I'm moving on to focus on just getting ready to do a massive move, which will also kind of change the course of my life. So, you know, no pressure, right? I don't think I've dropped in before. I'm very good at forgetting to do things. Oh, that's all right. I am too. But yeah, glad to see you around. I don't know if I've given you the spiel before, but like, I do tabletop RPGs, I do art streams like these, I do normal gaming game streams, usually for stuff like roguelikes or narrative adventure games or whatever. However, I'll also be moving into an apartment soon that has a entirely fleshed out streaming computer setup, so I'm gonna very soon have a whole lot more opportunities with what I can do than I'm used to here. So that's pretty exciting, at least. Oh, yeah, I'm really happy about that. Also, Coffee, I don't know if you've been in chat when it's been brought up before, but do you know any of Nia's secret words? You know, the ones that trigger her, like, Manchurian candidate-style bottom instincts? Well, you didn't hear this from me, because also, I can't totally remember if I'm remembering it accurately, but she does have a weakness to the princess word. But you didn't hear it from me. And I can be safe in the knowledge that I don't think that she actually watches VODs of my stream, and I'm pretty sure she's not in chat, so I'm probably safe in saying that. Well, I wish you the best of luck with your duel. Do you know how long your duel is going to be going, too? I don't know when I'll be finished with my stream, but I definitely do want to swing by to watch some of that spectacle. I know another thing that I'll keep secret for now. Oh, oh, you tease. Two to 3 hours. All right, so 2 to 3 hours and you start in 3 hours. Yeah, I should still be able to do that pretty easily. Come on. Yeah. Yeah. Alright, fine. You gotta make me duel with the lasso tool. I see how it is. Okay. To be honest, I'll probably be having, like, the duel stream up in a separate tab, you know, or, like, on my phone or something. So don't tell my own channel that I'll be cheating on it today with yours. In the meantime, though, I figure after I finish up Coffee the Pooh, I'll probably be doing a whole bunch of audience doodles, assuming that my audience is feeling like super jazzed and in it today. Okay, I wanna do a very light opacity white for this part. This is gonna be the lens. 25% should probably do it. Let's see. Come on. Embiggen. No, stop debiggening. Just embiggen. There we go. Nah, I don't really like how that looks, actually. Screw everything that I just spent a while doing. Hey, Cerberus! Welcome, welcome. We are just talking about how Coffee here is going to be dueling Nia a little later today, and that I hope that I'll be able to catch at least part of it because it's gonna be pretty entertaining, I have a feeling. By the way, how are y'all out there in chat doing? I've been having a pretty good day so far, I think. Oh, no, that's not what I want. I'm looking at new sheet sets. Not sure if I want to spend this much, though. Follow your heart. When in doubt. I'm doing well. Made a thing for Nia this morning. Oh? What'd you make, Cerberus? Let's go back in a little bit. Ooh, you get new sheets on Monday. Fun, fun, fun. My heart says, meh, you tell me when you're ready for new sheets. Fair. I slept in late and I'm trying to get the score to show up nice when I trying to get the score to show up nice while I wake up. Ah, okay. I wanted some of those cactus ones. Or something from the same company because those are so soft but no full size. Oh. I made a little dancing Nia emote. Oh, that sounds so cute! I can't wait to see it. Finishing up work before I get ready to do some other side tonight. Nice, nice, nice. I feel like I've seen other side before, but I can't remember the context of what it was like. From what I remember, it looked kind of like it plays a little like an XCOM game, but maybe with like a little more. Like, is it kind of a gothic, sort of a little cyberpunky XCOM kind of? It is souls a Souls-like in XCOM. Ooh, that sounds rough as hell. Does sound interesting though. Bloodborne XCOM, all in black and white and red. I mean, it's got an aesthetic, I'll give it that much right off the bat. Yeah, I'll try and take a look at that later then. I assume it's just like a single player campaign kind of dealy. The art style is what drew me into it first. Yeah, no, knowing what I know about you, that tracks. I also gotta give her a little shiny wet button nose. Yeah. a big ol' wet nosy. That's how you know your coffee kuma is healthy. Like a big ol' wet nose. Yep. Winnie the Pooh has some very pudgy cheeks, so I had to. Yeah, single player campaign. You fight through a shattered unreality trying to fix it by defeating manifestations of the villain's traumas. Every time you die, you gain more points for your next playthrough to buy buffs and stuff. Okay, so it's got like a little bit of a roguelike sort of edge to it. I can vibe with that. That sounds like it could be interesting. Well, I might have to check it out then. Alright, let's see. What else do I really need to shade? I guess I can do a little bit, like, under in this part. I'll be playing it tonight on stream if you want to get a feel for it. Sure! I'll definitely try and swing by. I usually hit multiple streams anyway, so might as well. Okay, let's do, yep, we're doing shadows this time. Oh, Cerberus, thank you so much. Thank you so much. 2 months subscriber. Thank you, Cerberus. If anyone has peculiar hearts, you can drop. Can you drop them in chat for me for Cerby? If you got those B emotes, spam them in chat for Serby's wonderful little gift there. Yeah. I'm also, so let's see, I think I'm 25 subscriptions away at this, or like I need 25 subscriptions total. So I think that's like another 10 subscriptions if I want to be able to get another emote slot. So that's my hope. For now, I'm gonna try and put my next two emotes that I got planned, on a higher tier of subscription, but I don't think they'll stay there if I can avoid it. But yeah, thank you so much. Hey, Fawn! How you doing? My day has been going really well. I finally finished the audition that I sent in today. And now I am just doing the stream to relax a little bit. Later in the week, I'm gonna have to be focused on getting ready to do all of the moving stuff next week. But for now, I'm feeling pretty good. I'm so tempted to spend my stimmy money on subbing to all my friends, but also I'm salty that half of it will go to Bezos, but I want that badge in everyone's chat. I understand, Coffee. It is pretty tough. I've mainly been justifying it to myself by just saying, well, I want to be able to visibly support X, Y, and Z people, so I'll do that much for them. If I can do more in some ways that aren't directly, even in just the tiniest, like, drop in the bucket way, helping Bezos, I'll gladly do it those ways too, but for now, this is the best way for them at least, so that's just what I'll have to do. Trying to get fully woken up. That's rough. Good luck with that, though. I wish you the best in your endeavors in trying to awaken yourself from slumber. Let's go to the next stage, which is going to be blending these edges. I know I kind of say this a lot in a lot of different ways, but honestly, and I hesitate to say it almost because I don't want this to come across as like trying to guilt trip anyone, but I do honestly really appreciate everyone who comes by to hang out, even for just little bits of time. Because this whole streaming thing has been so good for helping me get out of my comfort zone socializing wise, and I feel like I've made a way more friends than I normally would doing it. So even if you aren't able to come by often, I still really appreciate when everyone does. And is able to, obviously. It's true, though, Obsidia. I do honestly really appreciate everyone who stops by. There we go. I also have to be more active about that myself, though. Because, like, I want to support other people, too, so I'm trying to get more connections out there with more people, get to know them over, like, Twitter and rating them over here, even if I don't actually know them, that sort of thing. At least that's what I'm trying to do more often. Will I be successful? Who's to say? Also, one thing that I will say about the audition material, unprompted, that I felt particularly proud of was, in it, I straight up said, I honestly don't really... Like, if you decide not to accept me, that honestly isn't going to affect me either way. I'm gonna continue doing what I'm doing on my streams with or without you, so... Have a good one, I guess. Not in that particular kind of flippant wording, but you know what I mean, probably. If you don't know what I mean, sorry, I kind of just rambles. Like, don't get me wrong, it'd be really nice to be a part of a group that I can feel, like, appreciated in. And if this is somehow that group, okay, I guess. I'll consider it seriously. But if it's not, then I'm not gonna stress that. They are neither the beginning nor ending of VTubing. And I'm gonna keep doing what I am doing, the best I can do what I'm doing, either way. I'm sure that any of the other VTubers in chat right now have felt similarly. Okay, got that. Let's do a little bit under the jacket now. And you know, honestly, if Hololife doesn't want an ex-gender member who is going to constantly be running tabletop RPGs with other VTubers, that's their loss. God, it feels weird to have, like, enough confidence in myself that I can just say stuff like that. It's nice, though. You know? I wonder what I'm gonna do for dinner tonight. Don't really have anything prepared. I don't know what my folks are doing. It is a good kind of weird, yeah. See how that looks. Alright, that's not bad. Okay, now I gotta do a little bit down here. So let's. There we go. But yeah, I'm glad that you understand what I'm getting at. I feel kind of weird asking this, but Serby, do you VTube? I honestly have lost track of which of my followers are and aren't VTubers themselves. Because, like, this still isn't one of those hobbies that's, like, quite big enough that for most people, their fan base isn't also mainly people doing that thing themselves. I don't know yet, and I'm not sure if I ever will. That's totally valid, honestly. It's definitely, like, streaming as a hobby, much less as a profession, definitely isn't going to be an ideal fit for everyone. You do you. If you do decide, though, that you ever wanted to be a VTuber or to just have a VTube model, I think it would be a fun challenge to try and rig up a Cerberus type of model. I feel like I know what I would do for it, and I think it would be fun. But obviously I am not going to try and talk anyone into, like, trying to commission me, yeah. Man, I really wish so many of the songs in this, like, genre I really liked weren't named with the G slur in them. That would be really cool. Oh well. Streaming is a lot of work, and VTubing is probably more work, unless you have a lot of money. Yep. Yeah, pretty much. I've thought about streaming, but I would at least want a better mic than what I have. That's fair. It's also I feel like that's a good goal to set, because it's one that is pretty easily achievable, all things told. That said, I would highly recommend, while looking for mics, do not get a Blue Yeti. They aren't very good. Yep, I have sunk way more money into this than I thought I would. But, like, I have fun, so I count it. Yeah, yeah. It's as much a thing about, like, this is something... If it's something that you passionately enjoy in addition to it just being a job, I think that makes it way easily justifiable. Way more easily justifiable, you know? I think I might end up getting some more, like, buying some more assets for my channel from other creators too fairly soon. Not sure how much or what to do for that next, but we'll see. And hopefully more folks will decide that, hey, I like your art. I like your art and your product enough that I want to pay you this kind of commission to do this for me. That's like one of my dreams, or one of my goals at least, to have art nice enough that people will regularly want to buy it from me. Let's see. Well, the mic I have now is the built-in mic on my headset, which I got hand-me-down and kind of broke. Yeah, I mean, on the bright side, that means there's no place to go but up for your mic. I want to commission better standby screens and music. Same. I have people in mind too, but neither has commissions open yet, and I don't have the money anyway. The Blue Yeti Snowball is not very expensive and is good. I use it currently and bought a pop filter, and am only because I found I type obnoxiously loudly. Well, alright. If there's Blue Yeti products that work well, sure. I haven't personally heard many, like, good things about Blue Yeti mics, but I trust firsthand experience better than I do, like, general hearsay, so... Yeah, I guess they do make some good product. Okay. Scroll up a little bit. My partner uses the fancier Blue Yeti one and really likes it. Hmm. Alright, well, maybe Blue Yeti's just, like, massively improved its quality of service since I last looked into them. I'm willing to give them that benefit of the doubt. I was recommended the Snowball by some other streamer friends since I was using a headset mic before, and people said I should get a better mic. Yeah, a mic is definitely a big part of it. I mean, I know personally that for a lot of the streams that I go to, I don't even really stick around to actually watch what's going on for the most part. I almost always have like most of the streams that I go to it on as part of the background for me. Not because I don't like the people, just because like I have trouble focusing on just the one thing, and usually there's a lot of other things I need to do too. So, you know, multitask, that sort of thing. But yeah, I feel like that's part of, for a lot of people, why the audio component is so important to this kind of thing. Not that it was, like, something people were doubting was important, I guess. Looks about right. Let's go in for the schmooshing. You know, I don't always feel great about saying it, but to be honest, I think one of the reasons I started doing Doodle Days was because I feel like I need to keep drawing if I want people to, like, get commissions from me. And this way I had an excuse to, like, make immediate connections with people because, hey, everyone likes getting fan art, right? So this was definitely, at one point for me, a goal of marketing, but I think now that I've kind of grown out of the idea of really doing much business, for now at least, in art commissions, I've just been kind of like, well, I guess I'll just keep doing this anyway. I'm still enjoying myself either way. Even if I can't find work doing this kind of thing, I still like what I'm doing. I like seeing how people react to what I'm doing. Guess I'll just keep going then. And dang, if that hasn't been a kind of mindset that so many decisions in my life have been made with. Unrelated, the neighbor's kids are playing outside loud enough for me to know they're outside playing, and I check on them because they're good kids and I like making sure they're okay. This is like the first time they're out playing since the winter and they got otter pops. Oh, nice. I love my hula hoop obsidia and my viewers thought she was super cute. Well, thank you. Like I said, I've kind of given up for now on like trying to really be particularly financially soluble all on my own through stuff like art and streaming. So I think right now, for the most part, I'm just doing it because I enjoy it and people enjoy it and I enjoy people enjoying it. Which is a pretty simple reason, but I mean, that. It's just how reasons work sometimes. Excuse me. Okay. Either a lot of electro swing samples old cartoon sound effects, or I've heard this song weirdly frequently, and I'm not sure which it is. I'm hoping it's the former. Because the idea that by only listening to this thing like once or twice a week, I have still somehow exhausted all the new music I can get from it. It's kind of a bummer to think. Yeah, electro swing is really fun. I don't know about for anyone else, but for me, when I was growing up, my daddy dear had he had a record player, and like on a several times a week basis over dinner, he'd just take out a record of a jazz artist and would just play that throughout dinner. So I guess I just kind of like was raised on appreciating that kind of music. So when I heard this new version of the same old kind of music I already liked, it seemed like kind of a no-brainer, you know? There we go. I feel like I keep harping on this, but I am genuinely really happy to hear that, though, Obsidian. I'm glad that you and your chat both liked it. And it really does mean a lot to me when people like that. I like the stuff I do. I grew up old-timey music. On old-timey music, so hearing it with the electronic spin is great for me since I love the genre smash. Right? I remember when I was still in cryptid college, I would spend whole days just trying to find mashups of different genres that I liked with my favorite songs. Shit, I think Nia is secretly practicing, gonna lurk and get warmed up. All right, good luck, Coffee. I'll be rooting for you. I mean, I'll also be rooting for Nia because I like you both, but I'll technically be rooting for both of you, so that means I'll be rooting for you. Okay, so I don't know how universal of a thing this is, but does anyone else here really, really enjoy mashups of songs that have like no right to sound good together? Or like sounds that are very clear songs that are very clearly like put together as like a joke for the meme, but are also just really good? Like the one that I'm thinking of right now, it was well. There's two. The first one, every time I am getting ready for cosplay at a convention, the song that I always put on to pump myself up is a mashup of the like the main theme of the Pacific Rim movie with with what was it? The yeah, the with the M with the Motor City DJs, Come On and Slam. Yes. It is so good. So there's that one, and the other one that I'm just suddenly getting vivid flashbacks of was a mashup of it was a mashup of Evanescence Wake Me Up Inside with Bruno Mars's Uptown Funk. That one was fucking wild. Let's see. There was a mashup like post like oh, mashup like that post in Nia's server that was like a straight slapper. I'm gonna have to look that one up. Also, hold on real quick. I'm gonna see if I can find these songs to play during the stream because I mean, who am I kidding? I'm not actually gonna be making any money off of the VODs of this. I might as fucking well stream music, right? Besides, it's already a mashup that they're not using the original artist permission to do. What are they gonna do? Sue me for doing something that they did? If I talk all through the song anyway, that means that it will be open use parody anyway. 'Cause that's how that works. It's probably not how that works, to be honest. Okay. Sufic Rem, come on and jam. Okay. There it is. Okay. All right, I'm gonna play the two meme songs that I was talking about because I just love it so much. All right, so this first one is the Getting Ready for Conventions pump up song. All right, B, I have to lurk. All right, have a good one, Obsidia. I'll swing by a little later. I love this fucking meme. That feeling when, oh hey, I'm running low on milk, but I also don't want to leave my house. Here we go! Like, what the fuck? Why is this song so good? Hey you, what you gonna do? Hey you, what you gonna do? Hey you, what you gonna do? Hey, you, what you gonna do? Hey, you, what you gonna do? Hey, you, what you gonna do? I love that song. It's so dumb, but I love it. Oh, I was dancing? I didn't know if the motion capture would pick it up well. I'm glad to hear that y'all got to see me dance, though. I can't wait until I can do the do that kind of stuff all the time with my streams, and in better quality too. It's gonna be good. All right, now for the other one. This one gets a little wild. Funk me up inside. This one is so dumb! I love it, though! Okay, okay, very serious, very serious. This shit that ice comber shall fight for that white gold. This one for them hood girls, them good girls, straight masterpieces. Finding, smiling, living it up in the city. I'm too hot, hot damn. Call the police and the fireman. I'm too hot, hot damn. My dragon won't retire, man. I'm too hot. Hot damn. Say my name, you know who I am. I'm too hot. Hot damn. Man, boys, man. Funk me up and say it. Funk up. Funk me up and say it with my name. And funk me from my uptown funk. Funk. You can't funk up. Don't believe me, just watch. Hey, 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 oh, stop. Wait a minute. Fill my cup, put some liquor in it. Take a sip, sign the check. Julio, get the stretch. At the Harlem, Hollywood, Jackson, Mississippi. And show up, I'm gonna show up. Sooner than a fish start, skip it. Funk, 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 funk me up and I can't funk up. Funk me up and slow my name and funk me from my funk, funk. I can't funk up. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. Uptown, funk you up. Uptown, funk you up. Uptown, funk you up. Uptown, funk you up. Uptown funky up. Uptown funky up. Uptown funky up. Uptown funky up. Dance, get on it. We sexy then on it. We gay then on it. Don't brag about it, please show me. Come on, dance, jump on it. If you sexy then flown it. Don't believe me, just watch.
believe it, just watch. Come on! At this time, I'm feeling I've never seen. Feeling in the dark, but you again in front of me. Don't believe it, just watch.
Uptown funk you up.
Hey, Ventagram. Yeah, you came at a great time. I was talking about how I loved meme mashups that were actually just unironically really good. I'll play the one that I was playing earlier again. But first, I've got one that I have as a request here. So let me finish up the blending on these shadows, and then I'll load the next one. Also, hey! How did The Witcher go? I didn't see the rest of it after I had to leave. Did you Witcher it? Did you really have... I don't know. All I know about The Witcher is that you have sex with witches. So, did you do that, I guess? I'm sending a mashup request for you to play. Yep, I know. It went well. I got a little sleepy, so I ended early, but we did Witcher things. Geralt was sassy as hell. Good. All right, so the next one requested was... Okay, so this one was All I Want for Christmas mashed up with... I've been trying to avoid having the sex parse because I'm worried Twitch will be mad at me. Understandable. Very understandable. Toss a coin to your Ventagram. Okay, let's see. So that next one was... Also, Sad Bunny, I wish I could go to a mashup night at a club. That does sound wonderful. All right. All I Want for Christmas is the Black Parade. Oh, that sounds like it's going to be something. Okay, what the fuck is this one going to sound like? Oh, there's a couple of these. Okay. I'm kind of surprised that there's that many, but okay, sure. All right, so welcome to the Christmas parade. Is that the one you're talking about? You linked it? I didn't see a link. I know, I'm looking at Discord. It didn't give me any alert. I believe you. I know, I'm opening Discord. Okay, yeah, it's the same one anyway. Don't worry. Lazy to cook here, so. Alright, have a good one, Coffee. I'll be there later on. So make sure you don't lose too soon or win too soon.
Who are you? Defeat them, your demons, and all the non-believers.
Yep, see you later, Coffee! Alright, I think we're getting pretty close to done on this one. Last thing I need to do is I want to get the Poo font and then just write Coffee Kuma in it. This does work surprisingly well together. You have a feeling you've heard Black Parade one time before? Like, only one time before? It's a very good song. It's an image I can use. Alright. I have a weird ability. Yeah, it's the weirdest mashup that works super well. Oh, I got a phone call. Let me take this real quick. Just some Autobot. Hey, B, remember that way you sang Black Parade where it's like a 40s big band? I kind of do. I remember that better with Down with the Sickness. That one I can do pretty quickly and pretty easily. First, let me just paste this title card. Let me get this title card, copy image, then let's put the image in. There we go. So this is the kind of font that I'm trying to emulate for this, I think. Alright, I'll break you off a piece of that, though. So, if I recall right, that goes a little like, come on, get up and get down with the sickness, come on, get up and get down with the sickness, come on, get up and get down with the sickness. So, I imagine if I did it like that for Black Parade, it would have been something like, well, if I was a young boy, my father, he took me into the city. We saw a marching band. He said, son, when you grow up, will you be the savior of the broken, the beaten, and the damned? Something like that, I imagine? Was that anything like it, Epitome? Oh, wait. I know the one that I always did. Because this used to be a song that Epitome had attached, like, a original roleplay character's sad feelings to, so I latched on to it instead. Love of mine, someday
You will die, but I'll be close behind. I'll follow you into the dark, if no one should be there to greet you. And on your journey you embark. Hey, I'll follow you into the dark.
Well, do you remember that one, Epitome? Remember when that song used to mean something to you? Oh, I can be such a little bitch sometimes. All right, so this one isn't really a mashup, but it is one that I really enjoy still. So I'm going to put this on while I try and think of other meme mashups I've really enjoyed. Okay, so this one was... Okay, so, yes, this comes from one of my favorite 80s rock bands, Numb. It is by the 80s rock band Linkin Park. I also really love these kinds of remixes. Oh yeah, you'll have to clip some of those if you're able to. Oh, here we go. This is a good one. I think I've lost like 3 viewers so far to these songs, but I don't give a shit. Like, the original Numb that Linkin Park did, that was Depression when I was, like, 13, 14. This version of it is Depression when I'm, like, 28. It's like, I've gotten used to Depression. Nothing, when I was younger, it was, nothing really matters. But now it's like, hey, nothing really matters. Way cool! Any other requests before I put on another one of these remixes? I would like to do... Oh, wait, that's right. I promised I was going to play that one song. So this song is what I play whenever I'm going to an anime convention, when I'm getting, when I'm getting ready, when I'm getting in cosplay. There's always such an emotional aspect of preparation for me. It takes so much time, so much energy. So I play this whenever I do that. Everybody get up, it's time to slam now. Oh yeah, I did, but we got the raid after I did it, so I wanted to do it for the raiders that came by. Sent like three in Discord, your choice, all of them mashups of Century. Oh, okay, that's gonna be fun. So yeah, that's my getting ready for cosplay in a convention setting. Pump up music. Hope you liked it. Why is this coming out so thick? All right. Coffee. There we go. All right, let's see what we got here for mashup options. And also, thank you for sticking around, those raiders who have chosen to do so. Once I finish this picture up, I promise, going to be getting to the audience request portion. Okay. Oh, this is tough. You sent some good-looking ones. Oh. Okay, well, first I'll go with one that seems like it is made to appeal to the I was an emo teenager demographic, and then we'll go through the other ones, maybe. So this first one is Fall Out Boy, Evanescence, and My Chemical Romance mashed together. Whoa, starting off strong. Oh, that was so good. That transition, though. You can just leave me. Breathe into me and make me real. Bring me to life. Oh, now we're going to go back to Centuries or to Black Parade. Oh, there we go. So, hot take, the worst part about Wake Me Up is the butt rock, rough sounding, call and response part. The original song was just supposed to be her voice against music, and once I heard that version, it was so much better. If you haven't seen the updated version of Bring Me to Life, highly, highly recommend it. Your misery and hate will kill us all. So paint it black and take it back. Let's shout out loud and clear. Defiant to the end, we hear the call. Oh, no. Oh. To carry on. We'll carry on. And though you're shattered, don't believe me, your memories will carry on. We'll carry on. And though you're open and defeated, your weary widow marches on and on. We carry through the fears. All I'm saying, Epitome, is if the shoe fits that you feel called out, then this is the shoe calling the kettle black. Also, yes, Jess, this is a very fun, very good flashback. You heard me, it's the shoe calling the kettle black.
Thank you.
Remember me for centuries, and just one mistake is all it will take. We'll go down in history. Remember me for centuries. All right, it got a little hectic there at the end with the three-way mashup, but overall, I still really enjoyed that one. All right. Oh, I'll just say this also for, like, in general chat. If you have mashups, just, like, drop them in the chat. I will gladly check them out. And 100 points... if they are memes, if they are meme song mashups that should not work logically, and yet, here they are. All right, just so I'm not doing back-to-back mashups with centuries, let's keep the emo feelings going, this time with, Linkin Park in Evanescence. Oh, this one's gonna be intense. I can feel it already. It's so weird hearing that opening chorus without hearing the, like, do, 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 do. Okay, we're off to a strong start. Nope, nope. Expecting of me, put under the pressure of walking in your shoes. Ooh. Ooh, I really like. Oh, it's a back and forth duet. I love this. Oh, this is so good. Alright, they did a little pitch shifting, but I can totally respect that. Oh, right, that was a really good one. Now keep in mind, the original prompt is songs that shouldn't sound good together or are purely jokes and yet do. That said, as you have clearly heard, I'm also just taking song mashups that are straight up good. So if you got mashups that you love in your YouTube history chat, please feel free to share them with us. Don't worry, Epitome, you don't have to be the only one. Come on, mouse, let me control. Mouse, come on. Mouse, play nice, mouse. Here we go. Okay. Epitome, it's okay. I'm honestly saying you shouldn't feel like you have to be coming up with all of these. It's okay if we don't have them. Honestly. All right, this one we got Panic at the Disco versus Fallout Boy, a real classic pairing, I feel. Good vintages too. This is gospel for the fallen ones, locked away in permanent slumber, assembling their oh no. I just realized because of where I stopped drawing this, what I made. It's Coffee the Cum. It's Coffee the Cum, Coffee the Cum. No, Venti, I have not. Please drop the link in chat. Also, I'm so sorry, Coffee. I know you're not actually actively listening anymore, but I have to screenshot this for later. I'm just gonna save this real quick before I make it family friendly. Oh no, I had to switch channels to paste it. Hold on. Let me go back to the channel. Let me go back to the channel. Oh no, I have to start the song over again. How tragic. Oh no. Just who I am this week. Lie in the grass, next to the mausoleum. I'm just a nut in your bed. Soon as the light is on. Song. The gnashing teeth and criminal tongues conspire against the odds. But they haven't seen the best of us yet. If you love me, you love me. Down, down, down. Sugar, we're going dancing. We're your number one bullet. A loaded guard complex. Hunkered and bullet. We're going down.
I don't know the other parts of the song well enough.
We told the never was yours. Love, fear, or fear of falling apart. And sugar, we're going dancing. We're your number one. You may have found something cursed. I think that's bold words, considering some of the stuff we've listened to so far. Okay. Let's shift the size of this a little bit, and I think we're getting close to being done. No, I didn't want to do that. I wanted to disconnect it. Scale that. Move it over. Coffee the Kuma. Coffee the Kuma. Friendly little VTuber all stuffed with fluff. She's Coffee the Kuma. Coffee the Kuma. Truth be told, I never was yours. The fear of falling apart. Anchor that layer. All right. There it is. Okay, I see it in chat. Let me fix this part. Okay, let's also crop this image down. Let's take this. And subtract this, and let's move. Oh, no, just this part. Actually, down here might be the best place to fit it, because I was gonna put it up here, but I feel like that crowds out around her thumb too much. What do you think, chat? Do you think it looks better in the top left or the bottom left? I'm scared, Epitome. I'm scared. Alright, first. Yeah, sure. Top left would be, like, up here. And let me zoom in also a little more. So this would be top left. Yeah, that's what I feel too. Bottom left. Okay, let's put it like there, I think. Alright, now let's scroll up and let's listen to X Gonna Give It To You mashed up with Call Me Maybe. That sounds fun. And then we've got a trio of suggestions. Oh, okay, those are some interesting suggestions, Epitome. We'll see how it goes, I guess. All right, so first, X gonna give it to you. Maybe. X hasn't decided yet if X will or will not give it to you. X will get back to you on whether or not he will give it to you. All right. Okay. Oh! Oh, okay. Ooh. Cerberus, I sent you like 12 songs for me to choose from. You're next. Yes, I will gladly do whatever yours is next, Cerberus. Then we're gonna throw it. Song made me so happy. Thank you, Venti, for your gift. I can almost forgive you for what you did to me the last time you came over to my streams. All right, because I have to do this part all in one stroke, once I finish this, I will... Oh, you're gonna put on the kazoo, aren't you, you motherfucker? That's what I thought. All right. Let me first get out my timer. That's right, I can talk and kazoo, you motherfuckers. You can't stop me that easily.
I've learned from my mistakes.
Oops, dropped the kazoo. Alright, hold on. Let me fill this section out. Gotta make it nice and fluffy. Maybe. I don't know. I'll probably redo that anyway. Alright, let me get my timer out. Oh, thank you, Venti! Thank you so much! I really appreciate it. Any other subscribers in chat, please give Venti some nice warm bee hearts to thank them for that subscription. Alright, and 2 minutes starting now.
Okay, let's see. First we're gonna scroll up to get to Furry Full Song and see what that one is. Furry? What about Furry? Is it the one you sent in Discord, Furry? Or is this that one? I can play it. Or is it a different one? Oh no, here it is, I see it now. Okay, I'll just into the world. I hope you enjoy this for the next minute and 15 seconds. Okay, this is Raiden Robot Cadavian. Yeah, I think we're gonna listen to this in the same time. Yeah, I just did the chorus right here, and then I just followed in my face.
I love how my default for when I stop being able to come up with things to do in Kazoo, I just start singing memories. Oh, what is this one? What is this you've sent me, Cerberus? Okay, I'm a little nervous about all of these different graphics on the front cover, but I'll try it. Oh, wow. Okay. All right. Where's the twist gonna... Okay, there we go. All right, I can work with this. Oh, a trade-off. I don't even know what that one is. I'm glad I remembered to put my a mature content filter. Oh, Slim? Oh shit, Slim, you're here too? Oh? Sai? I haven't heard from you in years. How you doing, man? It's alright, Serby. I have the mature content filter on, so I'm protected. And if anyone has listened this long, then they're probably cool with it. Oh, there's the smoke weed every day. I was waiting for that one to come up. You know, I wonder, like, why there is such a high content of, like, rap songs when people do mashups that are, like, jokey. I wonder why that is. I even heard some Bill Nye in there. Well, that was nice. Whole bunch of little surprises. All right, so I think this one is done. I'm gonna quickly save it and export it. And then, chat, thank you so much for sticking with me through all this chat. I will open it up to some audience requests. So, if you have a request for a mashup to listen to or something for me to doodle, put it in the chat. Then like, comment, subscribe, follow, smash that... I already said like. Smash that like button anyway. Get in the comments. Tell your friends. Tell your family. Tell your enemies. What else can I do? I don't know. Hey, Heavy! No problem. You're just in time for me to show off the finished piece. Coffee the Kuma. Coffee the Kuma. Alright, let me open up a new canvas. Alright, so, yeah, I mean, I don't know. I might be, like, non-partisan in whatever makes them your enemy. Maybe they'll like me, too. Steal people's souls and have them follow? Sure, why not? Alright, so while I'm getting the next mashup, if you have any requests for another, or for something for me to doodle, please drop them in the chat. Okay, let's see. Alright, you've sent me a couple of them now, Epitome. Is there one that you want me to start with? If I wanted to post a mashup, do I post it in chat? Yeah, you can post it in chat. All right, let's see what this one is. A soft Highland cow. Okay, I can do that. So I'm also going to try as best I can with all of these to not actually look up any reference images if I can avoid it. So I'm going to try doing all of these from memory if possible. And then we can look together to see how right or wrong I was in making what I make. Okay, let's do like that by like that size. Okay. All right, now let's see. Let me start a new layer. Just so I'm not doing everything right on the background. Also, these will probably be all Oh, Coffee and Nia are alive now. I do still have 2 more hours, though, and I don't want to make it a habit of me, like, cutting my streams early unannounced. So if anyone wants to, like, listen or watch everyone's or multiple streams at once, or if you need to drop out of my stream, I totally get that. I'll be catching up with Nia and Coffee a little later. All right, we've got, oh, a Neil Cicerega song. Those are always good.
Welcome to Larry King Live. How do you explain Tim Allen?
Oh. Oh, okay. Okay, what's this one gonna be? Alright, so a soft Highland cow. I'm pretty sure I remember what Highland cows look like. I feel fairly confident in that. So first, what you want to get, you want to start with a nose, and those noses kind of look like this. And then they have the mouth that connects into the nose. Sort of like that. Yeah, I think that's right. Okay, and then cow heads sort of go. No. Okay, well, a Highland cow heads, because they've got the hair. Okay, and then they've got ears, which are kind of like. Now, there's a lot of grunting in this song. I probably should have been tipped off by the name of the song being Annoyed Grunt. It's still a pretty good one, though. Got noses that are kind of like that. Then they got horns, which kind of go like. Please forgive me for this mashup. I may forgive you, but will God? I don't know, I'm not God. But I forgive you. And then the cows got bodies that go like, whoop, big ol' hair. And then they got legs that go like, boop, 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 and boop. And then a little tail, which has a little puff at the end.
I can't wait to read this book. They tell me there's a story in the book about you having sex with a ghost.
Oh.
Oh, boy, yeah. But this was at a time when I was filming Ghostbusters.
Now, see, the danger of playing Neil Cicerega songs is they always all meld into each other. So I could go and listen to Bustin' 2 now. First, though, important question. Epitome. Is this satisfactory for a cow doodle? Or would you like me to try again? Here, let me also give this cow a little gift. I'm gonna... Come on. Put a little flower in this cow's hair. All right, Epitome, what do you think? Is this a satisfactory Highland cow? Is it soft and Highland and cow enough for you? Or do you want me to try again? I am not free until you tell me one way or the other. Meanwhile, I will pick the next mashup. This sounds miserable. Excuse me. I'm going to file a formal request for you to draw Gabumon at your leisure. Okay, I can do that. Two questions for you though, Venti. First off, do you want me to be trying to do this just by memory? And second off, do you want a full Gabumon or do you want a peeled Gabumon? I'm glad you like the cow, Epitome. Okay, so by memory and with the peel still on. Got it. Okay, by memory, Gabumon with the peel. Okay, let's see. So first, let's enshrinken the cow.
Deserve you, never gonna make you cry, never gonna say goodbye, never gonna tell you lie, hurt you.
Alright, so next up, a Gabumon by memory. Alright, this one is gonna be tough for me because, as I've talked about on my podcast, Digipod, a Digimon fan cast, which, by the way, after I move in with my partner next month, there's going to be another episode recorded again, so I haven't given up on that one yet. But as I've talked about on my podcast, Digimon has a very specific way of designing its characters in the early seasons, which I personally find very satisfying, but there is a lot of detail that you've got to remember in order to do them right, so gonna see what I can remember. Okay, so first off, we need a general shape. So I think Gabumon, because Gabumon wears the fur for the most part, and you said you wanted an unpeeled Gabumon, so that means it'll still have his fur. Let's see, I believe it's So let's move all this over away from the wall, so I have some more room to play around in. Okay, so let's see, he's got eye holes up here. He's got a big ol' nose. Alright, also, who in chat likes musicals, huh? How about some meme musical mashups? Let's do that.
To the bride,
and your sister, who is always by your side, to your union, and the hope that you provide, who will always be satisfied. This is interesting. I wonder when the mashup is gonna start. There we go. The only two song mashup I know of off the top of my head are Frontier Psychiatrist and Pop Culture. I mean, those are still pretty good ones. I'm just more looking for, like, meme-y or unexpected, or just really, really good ones for this, I guess. Every part of flame, this is not a game. You strike me as a woman who will never be satisfied. I'm sure I don't know what you mean, you forget yourself. You're like me, I've never been satisfied. Is that right? I've never been satisfied.
They're talking about sex.
Alexander Hamilton, where's your family from? Unimportant, there's a million things I haven't done, but just you wait, so. I've never heard Cruel Angel Thesis this slow before. Or maybe I've just never heard it on its own. It is slowed, okay. Alright, so let's see. If I recall, the ears kind of go like they're a little zigzaggy. Where are you taking me? I'm about to change your life. Then by all means, lead the way. I'm hoping DMCA doesn't teleport into your house like a SWAT team. I think I'm probably okay for today, I think. I mean, if one stream gets demonetized, oh no, whatever will I do?
Thank you for all your service.
If it takes fighting a war for us to meet, it will have been worth it.
I'll leave you to it.
Okay, let's see. Are there teeth? I think so. I think there are teeth. it's not the night, it's Alexander's eyes, as I romanticize what might have been if I hadn't sized him up so quickly. At least my dear Eliza's his wife. At least I keep those eyes in my life. To the bride, my sister, and there's always by his side. Union, and the hope that you provide, I will always be satisfied. Okay, so the fur isn't actually attached to his arms. I remember that much. It kind of like just drapes loosely because it's all apart. Like, the weird thing about Gabumon, when you really look at his design, he isn't actually anything canine. He's actually a lizard-like creature that dresses as a wolf. He's a furry. Gabumon is canonically a furry. All right, let's see. Okay, keeping with the mashup, Epitome, you're doing me dirty here. This is a song with one half that means a lot to me emotionally. We'll see how well it holds up. Yeah, he has a Viking aesthetic at this level, but with Gomamon, you switch over, and like in his later levels, he is literally a Viking.
Theodosia writes me a letter every day.
Keeping her bed warm while her husband is away. He's on the British side in Georgia, trying to keep the colonists in line. He can keep all the Georgia. Theodosia, she's mine. Devil doesn't discriminate between the sinners and the saints. It takes and it takes and it takes, and we keep it in any way. We laugh and cry and wake and make mistakes. And if there's a reason, I'm still inside. So many who tried. I'm willing to wait for it. I'm willing to wait for it. Wait for me. I'm coming. Wait, I'm coming with you. Wait for me. I'm coming to. I'm coming to.
I'm willing to wait for it. 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 I am
one thing in life I can control. It sounds like drumming. No, I'm not alone. I feel the rocks and stones echoing my soul. I'm coming, coming, coming. Also, what I remember about the first edition of Digimon, they are really weirdly veiny and muscular. Oh yeah, like, that isn't a complaint. I absolutely adore the Season 1 Digimon designs because they strike that perfect... So this is another thing that I talk about a lot on the podcast. I love the Season 1 Digimon designs because they feel so unabashedly punk. Like, at this point in the series, they aren't trying to appeal to, like, long-term fans or fan service. They're just doing things that are weird and grody and nasty looking, but really cool and creative and interesting to look at. It's early season Digimon. I won't say that number, that season one is like Tamers. That's fine. You're allowed to like things. I ain't the Digimon police. Alright, let's see. If no one else has suggestions for mashups in chat, I'm just gonna keep going through the laundry list that Epitome sent me earlier. Let's go back to one with some Fallout Boys. Some legends are told, some turn to dust and to gold, but you will remember me for centuries, and just one mistake is all it will take, will go down in history. Remember me for centuries, hey, yeah. Well, hey, remember me for centuries. You would wait and watch for far away. But you always do, but you be the one to work while they all play. And you lay. Who, Gabumon? Gabumon is very good, if that's what you mean. Alright, now. His legs are pretty stubby. I don't think they're, like, this kind of stubby, though. I think that it's more... Yeah, Gabumon! All of them were... Look, all of them were weirdly muscular. I was spacing out and looked over and saw him, Gabumon, and, Guillemot. Is it Gilomon? Gilomon? Guilomon? I can't remember, but yeah, those are both good ones. I also like, I really like the lore implications about how Guillemon is literally a homemade OC in that universe. Okay, I think, if I recall right, his feet are kind of like this. So let me out of the way now. We are the warriors who build this town. See, I fucking love the homemade OC Digimon. It was always pronounced Gi-O-Mon. Gi-il-mon is how I pronounced it. Digimon are weird. Digimon are weird.
And here's the frozen proof.
Huh? Is my mouth stuck open? Let me check the capture real quick. There we go. Fixed it. Yeah, I... like... I've got mixed feelings about that one. I felt like, as someone who had been watching from season one, that I really didn't like that one, because, like, I feel like the dichotomy, personally, between the Digi-destined and their Digimon partner, because they're, like, natural narrative foils for each other a lot of the time, worked really, really, really well, and I loved that dynamic. So when they got rid of that and just had the kids be the Digimon, that kind of just broke my love of it, you know? It wasn't the same dynamic. All right, let's see. You know, I'm going to do a quick break from all of the mashups to do another, like, 80s style song for something that I really enjoyed. So let me grab that real quick. Okay, this one is... Excuse me. I don't know why I'm burping now. I wasn't burping earlier. All right, so here we have the 80s remix of what I personally feel is the best of the of this artist's work, and certainly the queerest of the songs. I watched Digimon Try and I was like, meh. Which one was Digimon Try again? I haven't actually been able to watch new Digimon in a while, and I, at this point, have kind of just been, like, waiting on it, because I'll probably, if I stick with this podcast idea, get there eventually. Okay, so it goes down, and it, I believe there's also bottom legs to the hide that he's wearing. The movies where the season one Digi-destined... Oh, okay. Yeah, I saw that. I kind of saw it when it was coming out, or I didn't see it. I saw that it was coming out, but I didn't really do anything at the time. But that's kind of disappointing to hear. I wonder if there's stuff in it worth watching. I don't know. Again, if I stick with the podcast, I'll get there eventually. Probably, maybe. Who knows? Okay. So you're gonna start up their mashup? Oh, not mashup, remix. Any second now. There we go. Okay, now the hard part is the pattern at this point. Because I know he has one, and I know that it's like a tiger stripey pattern. Well, let me see if I can remember how that's supposed to look. I feel like he has something on his belly too, like a circle. Alright, so now the pattern on his pelt. I think that it's kind of like lion, not liony, tigery.
For a taste of it's alright. Your toxic love got me under. Taste of your poison paradise. I'm addicted to you. Don't you know that you're toxic? And I love that it's you. Don't you know that you're toxic? I'll take a sip from my devil's cup.
It's just it went and does some story elements that irk me. Oh, the Xbox 360 live anthem? Is toxic known to... Oh, I get it, because it's Oh, I'm the smart bunny.
And I love that it's you, don't you know that you're toxic? I'm addicted to you, don't you know? Taste it, I'm on a rush. Your toxic look at me.
Let's see, is there something on his tail? Phagomizer, maybe? Chat. What do you think? Does this look like a Gabumon? In just a second, I'm going to look up the reference and we'll see how off I am. Yep, but toe to tip, that's a Gabumon. Oh, why did I say tail to tip, that's a Gabumon? All right, let's look it up. Also, while I'm looking this up, next request in chat, please. Priority goes to if you have a request that has not been drawn yet. Okay, Gabumon. Okay, I'm... got my eyes closed. I'm worried. I can't close my eyes all the way in Digispace, so you're just gonna have to believe me when I say I got my eyes closed. It's loading. It's loading. Come on. Huh? Right, there we go. Okay, let's get a picture. Let's take a look. Oh! Okay. Okay. Yeah, I wasn't that far off. I wasn't that far off. Here. Side by side, look at that, two Gabumons. Yeah, I knew the arm part right, I got the legs right, the tail, there's a bend with no phagomizer, the ears should be more floppy, let's see, he's got more teeth here, the eyes obviously different. I remembered basically the pattern, though there's parts missing, of course. Yeah. For doing that completely by memory, that was pretty good, I think. Let me also name this guy now. So obviously this isn't Gabumon, but I will call him. Come on, Mouse. I will call him. Alright, there we go. It's Gorbomon. It's everyone's favorite Season 1 Digimon, Gorbomon. I choose you, Gorbomon! Gorbomon, use Howling Blaster! What's this? Gorbomon is digivolving. Gorbomon digivolved into Gorbubumon. All right, chat. What's next? What's next? We've still got an hour and 15 minutes left of stream. What's next? Hit me with another, chat. Hit me with another while I pick another song to listen to. Yeah, stretch. Thank you, Ethos Spot. Excuse me. All right, chat, what's next? Come on. Hit me with your best shot. Hit me with your best shot. Hit me with your best shot and fire away. Ooh. All right, Post Malone. You can get it. Ooh. No, Venti. I'm not doing... You can't trick me that easily. Besides, I said if anyone who has... Yeah, if anyone who hasn't made a request yet has a request, that's priority right now. Draw a cute dragon, okay. Let's see, I'll put dragon down here, I guess. Okay, so let's see, cute dragon. Now, there's a lot of different ways, I think, to make a cute dragon. But I'll start with a snoot that's kind of like that, I think. And then the head kind of goes like, come on. Okay, I gotta redo this. Something like that. And then... Something like that. And it kind of loops down and around. house. There we go. Also, welcome, welcome, Hemlock. I don't remember if I said that to you when you first came in. All right. Let's see. So, dragon mouth. I think a dragon mouth kind of goes something like, curve up at the ends, because it's a happy little Durgan. Good energy, huh? I'm glad you like it. All right. What about my favorite Gen 1 rookie Digimon, Acquaintancemon? You know, it took me an embarrassingly long time to realize that Digimon's name was a pun on palm leaves, Palmmon, and not Palmon, because, you know, she's shaped like a friend. Yeah, that one took me a while to catch on to. All right, let's look for general mashups of this band, because I feel like there are going to be some interesting ones for this. Let's see what I can find. Wait, what? Okay, I don't know how this one's gonna work, but I guess let's give it a shot. If it makes you feel any better, I was today years old when I learned that. Oh, it does. So this is apparently Radiohead's Creep mashed up with ABBA. Okay, now the dragon needs some nostrils. I'm a creep. I'm a weirdo. Also, wait a second, Epitome? Epitome, I had that revelation when I was recording an episode of Digipod. Did you not listen to it? Hmm. Okay. This isn't a very good mashup. Let's see what else I can get. Alright, here we go. And if this doesn't work, I'll just fucking put on Neil Cicerega. I'm gonna need to be up to date when you guys finally get to Tamers. That's right, I'm using a soft brush. I've never actually listened to the original song, so maybe someone here can enlighten me, but do we ever actually find out if or if not Annie is okay? Because I'm concerned. Do we know if Annie is okay, chat? We don't? Oh my god, has anyone checked in on her? God, I'm so sorry, Annie. We should have checked in on you. That's a pretty good one. Any other requests in chat for mashups before I just decide to put on a Neil Cicerega album? No, No other requests? You're moving to Coffee's stream? All right, Epitome. I'll be able to join you in a little over an hour, so keep track of how it's going for me, okay? Yeah, that's a good dragon eye. Alright, I'm just putting on a Neil Cicerega album. I guess let's go with Mouth Moods. Mouth Moods. Full album. Oh, gotta stretch. Hey, hot like lip gloss, how you doing? We're doing, I finished my normal 2-day art stream early this week, so I'm doing some requests at viewers' request. Oh, well, thank you. I really like me and other jackalopes too. Let's try using perspective. That'll do it, I bet. Yep, you done it again, perspective. You're back already? Was it that short of a match? Also, Hem, how am I doing so far? Okay, now this little fella needs some horns. Not just your kind of game? Oh, alright, understandable. Who was winning, by the way, though? Let's make these horns a little spinny, shall we? I think we shall. Nothing wrong with me. Something's got to give. Something's got to give. Something's got to give. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies, let the bodies hit the floor. 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 Nothing wrong with me. Nothing wrong with me. Nothing wrong with me. Something's got to give. Something's got to give. Something's got to give. Let the bodies, let the bodies, let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies, let the bodies, let the bodies hit the floor. Back in black. Something wrong, Epitome? I see your bottom texting. No, this isn't. He thought it was Waluigi? Like how that looks. Let's try something like that. Yeah, that kind of works. Let's stick with that for now. Megabytes. Think of that.
The sky is the limit. When you're thinking about the past.
It's on one disc. Can you believe that, chat? 5. I'm getting the feeling this won't be Mambo number 5, chat. Get on the floor, everybody wants the dinosaur. Open the door, get on the floor, everybody wants the dinosaur. Excuse me. What do you think so far, though, Hemlock? He is important and powerful. I'm glad. So let's give him a little finger. Let's make a couple more for him.
You don't get on the floor, everybody to the dinosaur.
Hey, Hem. When is your birthday party going to be running on Saturday, by the way? I want to make sure I can come to as much of it as possible. Welcome to Larry King Live. Oh, back to annoyed grunt. Thinking 5 to 8. Okay, I can do that. Wait, 5 to 8 EST, right? Okay. Did you decide what you're gonna do for your party too? Because I know part of it was going to be like some kind of collaborative drawing session, but I don't remember much else that was discussed. I was thinking Jackbox and like drawing requests games. That sounds good. I can't wait to play a furry telephone with you. It's gonna be so much fun. Don't know how I want to do that. Maybe like one person draws on stream while the others have it minimized. Yeah, that could work. We could have them like all open in different canvases that are like collaborative. This song. Now see, as an asexual, I don't really know how this song works for people, but I'm imagining this is what having, like, allosexual urges is like? It is. You boiled allosexuality down to its base components. You be bustin'. Okay, clearly this isn't gonna work, so let's just get rid of that for now. And let's draw again. Okay, so this obviously has to be a dragon that has like big ol' belly, right? Chumby is good. God, that is so valid. I ain't afraid of no sleep. I ain't afraid of no sleep. I ain't afraid of no bed. Can't relate. Invisible bed? Freaky ghost bed? Oh no! Nope, no, I don't want to 3D transform. Thank you for the offer, though. How's this gonna come around? Maybe he has like one claw on his stomach? Like, oh, I had such a good meal kind of a pose, you know? Scrub is a guy, can't get no love from me. Sitting on the passenger side of his best friend's ride, trying to holler at me. Oh, this one. Just a man and his tiger. Don't lose your grip on that tiger. Gotta have that tiger. Just a man, just a tiger, man. Okay, this little Durgan's coming along well. Okay, so now I need some leggies. I'm thinking he has these kind of leggies. No, no. Yeah, it doesn't even matter. What is it all? In the end, it doesn't even matter. Slim Shady, but he has terrible hearing and auditory processing issues.
Please.
YMCA.
YMCA.
I just want to stay at the YMCA.
YMCA.
I love this one. Just slowly swelling into a dramatic movie score. I'm not gonna do this the easy way because it's not actually easy. Young man, young man, put yourself on the ground. All right, so now for this Durgan's anatomy to work, I think it's got to be a pretty dummy thick Durgan. What do you think, chat? Yep. Pupper's downstairs saying something. I don't know what it is. It is same as the emotion I get from Harrison Ford. All right, chat, what do you think? Does this dragon look finished? What you think, chat? Is this dragon done? He is good and I love him. What is his name? What's this little dragon friend's name? Chomble, okay. See you.
I don't believe in anybody feels the way I do about you now.
Professor Chomble, he's mostly here to do research, but he's tenured, so he doesn't have to teach much. Good for him. Honestly, if he's put in the hours to get tenured, I can respect that. That is indeed a Dorgan. We have returned from daily bathing ritual. Alright. Welcome back, Heavy. We're in the final legs of tonight's doodle day. Okay, so Chomble. Now we need to add in... Today was kind of cold? The day in general or the bathing ritual? Because I know at least in my neck of the woods, it's at that fun time of year where the weather is too cold and too warm for whatever you wear. Okay, Professor Chomble. Chat, I got enough time for one more quick doodle. Does anyone have requests? Yep, Chomble is now canon to my universe. As is Cow and Gorbomon. Mm-hmm. Alright. I got enough time for one more quick request. Does anyone got one, chat? And at this point, I will allow repeat requesters. Anyone chat? That might be a little detailed for the amount of time I've got left. Can you draw a butterfly? I think I can draw a butterfly pretty quickly. Tell you what, to make it a challenge, I'm going to try and draw this entire butterfly in one line, which is going to be already pretty difficult. But let's see how I do. Okay, so butterfly. Probably best if I try and like start with antenna. So oh wait, I've got to move it because otherwise I'll be drawing over Professor Chombles. Okay, let's try this again. At the best place room-wise, still probably the best place room-wise. Okay, so I got to do a little smaller. Let's start with the wings this time. There we go, that's a butterfly. See, you got all six of the lines, you got the body, you got the wings. That right there, if I do say so myself, is a butterfly. Be thankful I didn't try to do the compound eyes as part of the one line. Yeah, butterfly. Alright, I think I still might be able to fit one more in here. Anyone else have suggestions for something really quick? Got time for one more request. A Trubbish, okay. Alright, speed time for Trubbish. Let's see, so you gotta start with a sack, And there's like this little knot thing at the top. Got the big ol' ears of trash. You got eyes like this. It's got a mouth with these really jagged pieces of glass for teeth. And it's got like the tears in the trash bag where its arms come out. And its arms are like trash too. It has one hand that's like whoop. That's trash too. And it's got little trash foots. There you go. That's a Trubbish. Trash-ish. Did you know this intro is 20 seconds? What? Wait, what intro? Tiny dragon that fits on your palm. Yeah, Professor Chomble ended up being the one good drawing in this entire doodle sketchpad. The Spice Girls part of the mesh. I did not know that. Huh. Alright, chat. Any other like 1 minute doodle requests you want me to do? A stick figure. Whoa! What the fuck? No, not like that. I just want to give a lighter color white. Well, there's no way that's gonna look good either way. Let's just leave it as is. Alright, a stick figure. I can do stick figures. I remember how to do those. Okay, so stick figure, let's put it here. Okay, so stick figure. Right, first I go like that, and like that, and at the top there's that, and this branches off, and then let's put a little leaf on it so you know what it is. Thank you. I'm very proud of this stick figure, too. I won't name the stick figure. All right, so thank you all so much for coming out today to hang out with me here. I had a really good time, and I hope you all did too. I don't want to delay too long because I want to head over to hang out with Nia and Coffee as they duel. I think it's going to be a very entertaining game. Excuse me. The next time I'll be streaming is tomorrow night, 7 p.m. EST, with RPG Night Group. Swing by then if you want to see a game. I don't know who's gonna be able to make it tonight, that night, so who knows what the game will actually be, but we'll see. For now, though, yeah. Thanks for hanging out with me. And now let's go raid. And since Coffee was my subject of the doodle, Coffee will be the one that I raid here. So raid Coffee Kuma. I think I recall right. Coffee Kuma, that's all one word, right? I'm pretty sure it is. Yes, okay. All right, and if you want to use a raid message, this is the one I'll be using. But yeah, thank you so much for hanging out with me. I hope you enjoyed yourself. I know I did. I'll be back again tomorrow night, 7 p.m. EST. You can always check out my VODs here or on YouTube, or follow me on Twitter as well if you want to get updates as they go live. But for now, let's go over to Coffee. Bye!